everyone. So in this video, we'll be talking about the CM1 specimen Q&As, which was given by the IFOA yesterday on the 30th July 2020. Now, what they have done is that they have taken four questions and they have solved it and showed as to how you all can use notations and solve your answers in the paper. So what we have done is that we have already solved one paper of September 2019 term, and we had taken almost all the equations and we have solved as to how all of those notations can be written in Word, right? So moving on, we'll start with the first question, which is calculate this notation, which is 10 bar 4 Q27 plus 1 using AM92 modality. Now, the things which I thought to be important, I have highlighted them. It is written that you should show your workings, but the intermediate steps can be shown using numerical values. No additional notation is required. So what they mean by this is that when you start solving any sum, you start writing with a normal equation. This is how you start with solving the equation, and then you split the equations and then you move on by solving it, then you put the numericals in and then you solve the numerical and give your final answer. So what IFO is meaning is that the intermediary steps which you show over here is not so important, and these will be not marked because it is conducting the exam in the world. So all of these will not be marked, but yes, your other steps, your numericals should be very efficiently and very legibly written so that the examiner will understand as to what you are trying to show. So this numerical which you see over here needs to be written properly. If you skip this, you will not get the marks you deserve, right? So the question is asking for the probability that a life aged currently 27 plus 1, which is 28, the life moved into the select modality last year, will die between the ages of 38 and 42. So I'll just open my Word and show you all how to do this in Word. So moving on, we'll start with the very first question over here, and it says that this entire equation, we have already solved it. If you're following my classes, we have solved this in our last class. But just because for those who haven't followed my classes, I will just give you all again the brief idea about how to solve this. So this can be again written very simply by using this notation, 10/4. This slash, you can find it above the enter key. And then we'll write the small q. Do not use the capital Q. It becomes difficult and also it becomes wrong. So we have 27 plus 1 as the age, so we need to write it within the brackets. If we had only one age, just like here, we do not have to give it within the brackets, right? So we give 27 plus 1 is your age, and then we give equal to. This thing is important to write because you can skip these intermediaries steps as told by the IFOA, because the marks has been given to the last two lines. And when you see something which is written over here, it says, let me just scroll down a bit, it says that only last two lines are required for full credit, which means that only these two lines are required in order to get the full credit, even if you do not write this line. Even if you do not write this line, you will get full marks, which is 3 marks for this question. So I would suggest you all do not go into writing so much that it will take up all of your time. So start from today and reduce your time in these questions wherever you can, because these are 3 mark small questions. So you can just, instead of writing these 3 lines, you can straight away write numericals, because this is now allowed by the IFOA. No marks will be deducted from you all, right? So we'll move on and we'll start doing this very simple thing over here. So So what you can do is you can just simply skip the first three lines and then just simply move on to the last two lines and it will give you full 3 marks. So I'll just show you all the very first line over here for those who haven't followed my earlier videos. 27 plus 1. And then what they have done is they have taken X, simple X from your keyboard as the multiplication sign. And then they have written 4Q38. So in my earlier videos, what I did was instead of this multiplication, instead of using X from your keyboard directly for multiplication sign, what I did was I used the star sign as given by the IFOA notations earlier. Both are, I think, both can be used because both are given by IFOA. Even this is now given by the IFOA stating that you can use X instead of using a star, and also you can use star. So both are valid, both are equally valid, both can be simultaneously used, right? So let me just go with the star because I think you will not confuse yourselves when you use star. When you use this X symbol over here, it will confuse you from whether it is a multiplication or whether it's an X, right? So this is how, and then you can just simply write these. You can simply skip these two lines over here, which is not at all required, which will not be given marks. This is what matters. This, so hence you need to, as this is CM1, you need to write minimum of 4 to 5 decimal places. So you need to write these decimal points. Minimum of 4 to 5 decimal points is required. Okay, so moving on to the next question again is given by the IFOA stating, which is, let me just extend this a bit. So we have calculate 2.75Q84.5 using the method of UDD, which is uniform distribution of deaths. Basis is ELT 15 females. Now what it shows that you should show your workings again, but the intermediate steps can be shown using numerical values. Again, notations is not required to get full marks. So over here, what you need to know, one thing which is very good for us, it's a good news for us, that this question earlier, if you see April 2019 question 2, April 2019 term paper, you'll see that this question was of 3 marks. But now they have made it 4 marks. They have given extra marks to us. Extra marks has been allotted to this question for typing. So they are considering that typing will take you some extra time instead of writing, because when you are writing, you are used to it. So when you start typing, it will take some extra time of yours. So they have given 1 mark extra to this question, which is a advantage for us because this question is really simple. So moving on, what they have done, they have solved it again without much use of the notation. So over here we start with the very first, which is 2. This is something, this step is something important because this will tell the examiner that okay, you have understood the question, you know how to break the question, how to break this expression and then solve it. So this will fetch you half a mark. So it says 2 point, let me just write it down for you all. It's very simple, we have done this a lot, but then for your convenience, for those who are watching my video for the very first time, so here we start with the equation which is given in the question, 2.75 Q 84.5. so it's 80, let me move the cursor away, 84.5 equal to, this is 1 minus, and what I can do instead of writing again, I can just simply copy this entire thing down, right? This is what we have been doing. This is what we have been doing because then it becomes easier and you do not have to write your answers again and again. So this, after this we have the entire thing. Now this step has been given a 0.5 marks, so it's important that we write this step as well, and this step will obviously be stating that you know how to solve, how to proceed ahead in the question. Okay, so 0.5 p 84.5. again, this which I am writing over here is not required. Again, you can use the copy paste thing. So you can simply, let me just copy this entire thing and paste it over here, because we'll just have to then change the values, some of the values, and then we are good to go. So start, I'll also be making one video on the shortcuts, on the various shortcuts which we can use. So it's very important that we also understand that the use of shortcuts are very important when we are typing, when we are efficiently typing, right? So here we have, we are left with 84, and we have 87 over here, right? So this is how I have typed the first expression. This will fetch me 0.5 marks. Moving on, what they have done, they have taken separately all of these and solved it, and then given the final answer at the end. So what we'll do, we'll just copy this from here, copy this and paste it. Once you paste it over here, now again you will see that this expression will not give you any marks. So this expression will not give you any marks. Instead, directly writing this will give you a whole of 1 marks. So let me just skip this, because this is not fetching me any marks currently. Also, they have said that you should reduce the usage of notations. We are willingly giving marks. We are not giving marks to the intermediate notations which you write. We are straight away giving marks to the numericals. But the numericals should be well explained. You just can't simply write this equal to 0.95421. Even if your answer is correct, they will not give you whole of the 1 marks, right? So you need to write this entire thing. We'll do that, and then you can also always, when you have time, you can give these steps, because there is no harm to it, and you are welcome to give this step over here. So let me just type it down what they have given us. Instead of again x, I am using a multiplication. For multiplication, I am using the star sign as given by the IFOA in the earlier notation. 0.5 into Q84, so it's Q84. Please give spaces in between. Giving these spaces are really important. You should give one space either before or after this multiplication, so that it's understandable, right? And then we simply solve, we write the whole of the numerical over here, and we give our answer. So you can do this by just simply writing the numerical. I'm not doing that in my video, right? Moving on, again, we have taken this step. So again, this is not important. They have straight away given 0.5 marks for the numerical. So this again is not important. What you can do is you can just simply copy this, paste it over here, and then equal to, you can move on by start writing this other equation which you see, right? So this is again not important. This step L87 by L85 is not important, but writing the numericals correctly is important, and is what which will fetch you your half a mark of this part, right? Moving on, similarly 0.25P87, again you all can see the marking distribution. This entirely will give you 1 mark, but the intermediate notation which you have written over here will not give you any marks. So you can skip that, and you can straight away move on to write the final numerical value, because it is straight away given over here that only the last 2 lines, as you saw in the previous question, will give you marks. Similarly, here also they are saying that the intermediate steps of notations will not give you any marks, but the numericals which are written very nicely, accurately, correctly, the numericals has to be correct and will give you the entire marks, right? Once this is done, what you can do is you can then, once you have solved it, what you can do, let me do one thing, because this becomes a little difficult to understand as to this is answer one, this is answer two. So you can make it bold. And also, as I said in my previous video, try doing each question in each sheet. Like for one paper, for one sheet, take one question, take one solution. Also, I'll be giving a lot of shortcuts. I'll be making a video, dedicated video on that, and also I'll be making a video as to how you can give header and footer, and so that it's understood that okay, you have more pages to continue to, and the examiner will not skip any question in between, right? So this is how, once you have written this, you can then simply again copy paste this entirely from here and paste it over here, and then just simply proceed equal to, and then take all the values from the top which you have calculated, put it over here, and these two lines will fetch you a whole of 1 mark. So it's very important that you need to know that where marks is given. So full marks should be awarded. This is what I have highlighted, which I consider to be very important over here. Full marks should be awarded if no notation is shown, provided the method used is clear. So full marks will be given to you all even if you do not use the intermediate notations, as I said, and you directly use the numericals. But it should be really understandable, it should be legible, it should be clearly speaking about the question. So you all can not just write anything, you all have to give your equal amount of spaces. So as you can see, there are a lot of spaces in between and it looks very neat, and then only you will get your full marks, otherwise you won't. Moving on to the third question over here. In the third question, they are saying to calculate the force of interest is given is a time of a function, and at any time t, measured in years, is given by this formula which you see. For time 0 to 6, it is given by this. For time greater than 6, it is given by 0.12. Find an expression at, which is the accumulated amount at time t of an unit investment made at time 0. So what I need to do is I need to calculate at, expression for accumulation from 0 to t. So I have to only consider the very first one. In just my previous video, I showed you all how to deal with this kind of an expression. But here they haven't used delta at all in their answer. They have just directly done with the solution. So let me just move on with the very first part over here and start typing it down within my word. I'll move on to the new sheet over here. And then what I will do is start with the very first one. In this, they are saying to calculate an expression at, which is the accumulated value at time t for time 0 to 6, for times between 0 to 6. Now again, as you all can see, they have given marks for this notation because it is obviously very important, and this cannot be written in numerical terms. This is an expression, this has to be written in terms of notations. As I showed you all how to solve this, I'm not going into the details of CM1, but I'll just give you a brief idea on how you can solve this. This is nothing but exponential minus integrating it from 0 to t, and what you are integrating inside is this expression which you see, right? So this I have done in just my previous video. So you can write exponential as exp, or what you can do is you can write e to the power, your entire expression in brackets. So I will go with exp. Also the IFOA has stated that. Now within the brackets we have integral. So exponential integral. Now integral can be written as int, then we start with the lower limit, then we give the lower limit, and then we give the upper limit. So over here my lower limit is 0. Do not ever confuse in this, otherwise you will not get the entire marks, right? So this, then we give a colon, and then we give what is the expression you need to write within your integral. So this is the entire expression which you need to write: 24 minus 0.02t multiplied by dt, and then you simply close your bracket. So this will state, okay, this is the integral starting from 0 to t, and this is what you need to write within your integral. Okay, then we have the entire thing is solved over here. Again, 0.24, for multiplication I'm taking the star sign, t minus 0.01 star and then t square. So again t square, for that we have taken carats. So it's very important, as far as I think you all have been following now, is that the use of brackets is very important, different kinds of brackets, the use of space is very important. So these few details are very important when you type your answers down. Then for the second part, let me just go to the second part. What is the question? So this is your expression, this is your final expression for AT, and it both these lines will fetch you 2 marks. For 6 less than T, AT can be written in the form of e to the power A plus BT. Derive the values of A and B. Now over here, they have asked to derive the values of A and B. This is the expression given for time after 6, greater than 6. So we have to write this entirely. Also, this is a question which is not of any past paper, so they have made it on their own. And we'll also follow the marking scheme which is given by the IFOA alongside, so it becomes easier for us to know that for what all we are getting full marks, right? So for 6 less than T, or vice versa, so first of all we'll have to calculate for T less than 6, and then we'll calculate for greater than 6. For this, our accumulated expression is given by exponential, again 0 point. So what you can do, let me just copy this entire thing now. So this is the same, right? This is the same, because we have just seen in the previous part, we have just calculated this in our previous part. This is there, we have just copied and pasted, and we have got the entire 1 mark for this. Moving on, then we have to calculate A6. Make sure you have your pen and paper with yourselves as well, because maybe you have to do certain steps which you do not want to show it in word, but there are steps which you have to do, so you can do it in pen and paper, right? You can do that. Exponential, and the answer is 0 point. You need to calculate this and just put it over here, and it will give you a 0.5 marks. Then we say, then for T which is greater than 6, we have AT expressions given by A6 multiplied by, I'm using the star sign, exponential, and we have the equation as 0.12 multiplied by, so it's 0.12, you can see 0.12, so we'll write 0.12 multiplied by T minus 6, because this is the time greater than 6, right? For this we have, so I am using tab button. This is known as indenting. Indenting is something which is important because it looks really neat. It looks really neat. So indenting is something which you can prefer using. Just click on tab and you'll move 4 to 5 spaces ahead. So here we have exponential 1.080 multiplied by exponential, and we have this entirely. So let me just copy again and paste it over here. Moving on, exponential. So see what they have done. They have not shown any intermediary steps. As you can see, no marks allotted for this. No marks allotted for this. Simply for this, you have your entire mark. But I would suggest you all, this is a sum which requires certain basic explanation. So even if you do not write this step, even if you want to skip this step, you have to write this step, because otherwise it will not be clear as to you have understood or not, or you have done it on your own or not. So these are the things which IFOA is considerate about, as to why and how you have solved your sum, right? And see, directly they haven't showed anything. They have just calculated all the steps, and they are saying, so the answer for A is 0.36 and B is 0.12, right? This is all they have shown, and this entirely will give you how much marks? 4 marks, right? So this entirely will give you 4 marks. But if this would have been in the normal case, this part wouldn't have been of 4 marks. So they have given extra marks for typing, for because this time the exam is in Word, right? So moving on, very simple, what they did was just copy and paste your values and you are done with your answer. The final question says part 3, calculate the present value of 100 due at time 7. So you need to calculate the present value of 100. So I'll do 100 by A7 is what we need to do. So we'll give the third part as present value is 100. This step is very important. And the examiner will know, okay, you have idea about how to proceed. 100, and then you write exponential. So this is in denominators. So whatever expression you wrote it over here, it becomes whole in minus, right? 0.36 plus, again, I would have copied this as well. So you can just simply copy instead of typing it down again. I think copy paste is very simple. Copy pasting saves a lot of time. Exponential minus 1.2, and this will give me an answer of 30.12. But make sure you have a unit over here, $100. So it's important to mention the unit dollar, otherwise you will not get your full marks, as I talked about in my last class. To get this dollar sign, what you can do is you can simply go to the insert tab, symbols, and in here you can select the dollar sign which you have, right? 30.12 is your final answer. So this is how you solve the various sums given by the IFOA. This was the third sum. We'll move on to the fourth sum. It says a life insurance. Now this sum is again adapted from the CT5 September 2018 question, and there it was of around 4.5 to 5 marks, but now they have allotted extra marks for typing, and which is 6 marks. So they have allotted 1 to 1.5 marks extra to this question just because you are typing it down, not writing it down. A life insurance company uses 25-year decreasing term assurance policies to lives aged 40 exact. The death benefit, payable at the end of the year of death is 5 lakh in the first year, 480 in the second, and so on. For 12 years, in the 25th year, the final amount should be 20,000. Premiums are payable annually in advance for 25 years until earlier death. Show the annual premium per policy is approximately $643 using the basis below. So AM92 ultimate we need to follow, 4% per annum is the rate of interest. Now this entire sum is given in September 2018. So I'll just show you all this September 2018, and beside to that, I will compare it to the solution which was given for September 2018. So this was the solution which you all can see over here was given for, and you can see the marks allotted is 4.5, whereas over here the marks allotted is only is 6. So it's great, right? This is the sum which they have given now. How to solve it? This was the sum how we did when we were writing. So this, you can see the marks difference as well. This is the premium equation which you see on the top. They have taken all the steps. They have done all the steps. When you just go through, they have done all the steps over here. But instead, they have obviously used the notations. So the very first says P equal to 520,000. Now this is again a term assurance. So for term assurance, we write TA, age 40, and then duration in these brackets, which is less than greater than bracket. For increasing term assurance, it's I and in bracket TA, so we have done this also in our previous class. ADU also we have seen, ADU 4025, how we do that. So this entirely, they have solved it over here using the notations. So what I'll do, I'll just show you all quickly as to how we can again type this in Word, although we have done this a lot many times now, but just for showing it again, we'll solve this, right? So this is our fourth question. This is our fourth question, and we'll move on to a fresh page over here. Fourth question, and we'll start with the very first expression of ours, which says P equal to, P is for premium, 52 1 2 3 4. Make sure your zeros are correct. Then term assurance factor, colon 40 is the age, colon duration is 25, minus 20,000, and then we have the increasing assurance. So I'm using again star. Again, you can use the X as given by the IFOA, but I find that this is not confusing. X for me sometimes gets really confusing, right? 25 for duration, and we just simply close the bracket. Divided by, we have ADU 40, and then again within the brackets we have 25. So this is how, see, this is how, even if you move to the next line, doesn't matter, because what you can do is you can move to the next line from this part, and it is easily understood. Or what you can do is, if this is the cases, we learn in our next class how to decrease the margin of our page as well, so that also we can do, right? So this is our first expression. Now you all can solve this, where TA, this entire expression which we saw in our paper, in this paper, where the term assurance term is equal to the endowment assurance. So this is endowment assurance. For that you write EA, V to the power, V caret 25 multiplied by 25 P 40. So that is also what they have written in their paper. See, they have written the exact same thing. I'm not doing it again. With this, we have done a lot. Again, they have solved it using numericals. So this entirely, the very first equation will fetch you 1.5 marks, which is huge. Earlier, it would have fetched you if you would have solving it in September 2018. So they have just written 4.5 marks, but now it will fetch you entirely of 6 marks, right? Moving on, we have over here something which we were discussing and we were doubtful for in our last class, was that for the whole life, as the IFOA has not stated anything for the whole life over here. As you can see, 25 multiplied by A65, which is the whole life factor, plus IA, increasing whole life, 65. So for this, they haven't given any notations earlier. Now they state that A65 can be written as WL. Exactly right, like we write for term assurance, exactly like we write for endowment assurance or pure endowment, right? We can write whole life WL, but for IA, instead of going into this term assurance, what they have said us to do is to simply give IA colon 65. This is what we did in our previous class, where we assumed that this is one of the possible approach. Also, I had mailed to IFOA regarding this, but now they have issued a question answer bank for that, so it's very easier for us to understand. It's very helpful that they have done this. So I'll just give you all this last expression, which is here, term assurance 40. Again, I do not have to write this again, because I can just simply copy from the above step, just for showing you all how this can be done. We have 40 minus V to the power 25 multiplied by 25. If you all are confused with this expression, you can again write this within the bracket. That can also be done, because then this entirely is again multiplied. So let me move on to the next line. Use tab, and then we have 25 multiplied by whole life, which is A, 65. So for that they have written whole life plus increasing assurance EA, 65, and we close our brackets. So this is how they have written this expression, and this will fetch me 2 marks. Otherwise, see, again, writing of this expression is not giving me any marks, but writing of this numerical is fetching me 2 marks, and so solving it give me 1 marks. So again, I'll just show you all very quickly. The very first step, which is obviously very important, this gives me 1.5 marks. Then you can straight away, instead of writing whole of this, what you can do, you can write term assurance. You can copy it from here, term assurance factor, copy paste it over here. Instead of going through these steps, you can straight away go through the last step. But I would suggest you all, since this is of 6 marks, not of 3 marks as was the first question, you all should write this expression. And obviously writing this will give you marks. Otherwise, if you write this and you do not write this, it will not give you marks. So these two steps are really important. These two steps will give you 1.5 marks. Even if you skip this portion, writing these two lines will give you your 1.5 marks. Even if you straight away write this, it will not give you your marks. You will have to mention this step. This step which you see is always very important in all the questions. To write all your numerical values is very, very, very important. Make sure that you do that. So here I don't think it will take much of a time. So I hope that you all, for 6 marks, you have to write 6 lines over here. 6 lines in which we have 2, 3 lines numerical and 2, 3 lines of equations. So then we wrote this, where we saw they have given for whole life WL 65 and IA, they have just kept it IA colon 65. So this is how we solve our entire expression and we get our marks, get our final answer. Do not forget to use the notation, the unit, dollar unit. Otherwise, again, 0.5 marks will be deducted. So this entire thing is for your 6 marks. Here you have to give entirely everything. You can't skip anything, because then only you will get your 6 marks, right? In cases where you have just 4 mark questions, 2 mark questions, in those cases you can give full of numerical values. But here, in this case where you have 6 marks entirely, you will have to write entire equation. So this is it for this video. Thank you. In my next class, I'll be making a video, short video on the useful word notation, word shortcut keys, and also how to present your answers really neatly for examiner to understand. Thank you.